left side to push her bad rides. It's no surprise, cause she's taking to this dance. She's taking up the gas. She's fast when it comes to the gas. By no means average. My own, she's gonna have it. Maybe you're a perfect 10. I wanna get in. Can I get down so I can win? I like the way you work it. No diggity. Got to back it up.
I'm like, what's up? I'm down with Daryl Scott. Straight picking in the goods from the thrift shop. Ice on my cabin is so dang frosty. Folks like,
dang, that's a cocoa honky.
Like, we all. With little dummy rocking ears on my feet, I be kicking and shaking it with straw on my dome. Little diggers like, here, who would play her own home? I'm gonna pop some tang. Oh my god, $20 in my pocket. I'm looking for a come up. It's
folks that drove up from Florida. I was like, man, y'all are bored in Florida.
Hey, I drove down to West Virginia.
West Virginia? Man, well, I can see that. No, y'all, we're thankful that y'all would do crazy stuff like that. Drive different places to come and see us. And I don't get it, but I'm thankful for it. Because we're just like anybody else, you know. We grew up in a little old town. Really little town. Six people in my graduating class, that's the truth. Always some smart aleck. Read the valedictorian. Nope. Not me.
We in the top five?
Top six, pal. One in every crowd. I'll show you up. But thankfully, I learned a trade. And I didn't follow that path either. Turned to bluegrass music with my boys here, and I tell you, we couldn't be any happier. We started out doing this journey, my boy Junior, I got two boys, Junior, both of them on stage with me for a long time. Junior, he's now a performance artist and picks up cinder blocks with various body parts. We're proud of him. And then my other boy, Junior, he's the one that got us to doing the YouTubing and all that kind of stuff. And we was playing at this place called the Chinese Burrito. True place, Forsyth, Missouri. And he gets his camera phone out and went to videoing us and stuff. He says he's going to put it on the YouTube. I said, don't you put that on the internet. Folks will steal everything we got. And the next thing I know, our video caught a virus. And it was passed around like herpes at a college campus. Never seen anything like it. And next thing I know, we're playing the Grand Ole Opry and playing CMA Fest in places like Randy Wood's Guitar Shop. Simple as that. So we're that thankful to do it. And it started with this little song right here. This is a song that he put on the YouTube to kind of started the whole deal for us. It's an old timey song by the Black Eyed Peas.
Good night. Tonight's a night, yeah.
good night. Tonight's gonna be a good night. Tonight's gonna be a good night.
That's where it all began. But it ain't where it began as a kid. Our interest in music started right there at home. We was raised on an alpaca ranch in north central Arkansas. A lot of you know alpaca is indigenous to Arkansas. And my family had one of the first working alpaca dairies in Arkansas. The only one in the county. And my daddy, he figured out ways that he could make different garments and stuff out of the wool. And he started making women's undergarments. And he made cheeses out of the milks and stuff. And his dream was for one of his alpacas to end up on your plate or in your wife's britches. He always said that. We come in from a long day out there in them fields milking them alpacas, and we had free range alpacas, so they was hard to milk. They're quick once they get spooked, boy. Out there having to carry them buckets, them old alpacas running full blast. You was out there trying to milk on them. Once we got the genders separated, we found out our milk production went right up. It was hard to keep the males beat off of you. Once they figured out what was going on, you know. But the milk production went up. But I'm telling you, that the concept never did grab on. So now we just trick them into thinking it's feeding time and slaughter them and making sausage out of them. I'm kidding. We don't do that. But alpacas, our trade, we'd come in from a long day of milking, and Mom would have supper going, WSM out of Nashville, Tennessee. And that's where we started loving bluegrass and country music. We were listening to it with our own ears, right there in our own home. And I believe it was Ernest Tubb was the first one I ever heard sing this song. And I thought, if we ever get to do a record, I'm going to put this on it. And it's one of our favorite songs to play. It's a little song called Milkshake. La, milkshake ranked on the fourth of the yard. Their like it's better than yours. Turn right, it's better than yours. I can teach you, but I have to charge. Milkshake ranked on the fourth of the yard. Their like it's better than yours. Dang right, it's better than yours. I can teach you, but I have to charge. No, you want it. That thing that makes me what the guys go crazy for. You you're smart. La 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 la. They're like, it's better than yours. Dang right, it's better than yours. I can teach you, but I'll have to charge. Wouldn't be the head master, then I picked the wrong time. Thank you so much. Boy, it's good to be here. Had to take a little break from the road, just a few weeks, you know, some community service. But we're glad to be back or doing her. Hadn't had a chance to spend very much time with the family before that, so it's been nice to have a little time with the family. We even took us a little vacation, went to Charleston, and that was a good time. I had some good food over there. I went to this place one night, it was called Spice. And the real spicy food. We walked in there, and old boy was trying to talk us into different sample platters. And this one, I said, "What's a ghost pepper all about?" He goes, "Oh, you heard of that?" I said, "Well, what's that all about?" He goes, "Just a little pepper." I go, "Okay, well, just bring me some of that there, because you know." And man, y'all. It is the hottest thing I've ever had, like, lit me on fire. My skin tightened up, my lips swelled up like Bruce Jenner just The guy come back over, I'm like, "Hey, I'll pop the something real fast." He said, "Little pepper, very hot." That wasn't his accent at all, but I don't know where. That was not even close to his accent. I did not do that justice, but because I don't speak Spanish that good. But anyway, he comes over, you know, and I said, "I thought you said just a little pepper," and he said, "Like very hot, you know," and that was not the worst of it, to be honest with you. 2:30 that morning. I woke up like straight up out of bed from a deep and felt like a pod of dolphins. Trying to escape my lower intestine. Long night. And so that's when we wrote that instrumental. Set the woods on fire. Ice cream, that should be it. Tell you what, I miss my days like this when we're out here laughing, having fun. That's when I get to thinking about it. Some of you might know my wife and daughter being held captive at Area 51. I believe that with all my heart, especially after watching some of them new shows on the Discovery Channel. Brings a lot of that to light. I was hoping I'd see them on there, but I did not see them. I met her one evening. I was fishing on Greer's Ferry Lake. Kentucky bite, full moon. A little bit cloudy, so the water was just right. All of a sudden, I see this light coming down straight at me like a Jeff Bezos rocket. Just coming straight down. And you know the Jeff Bezos rocket, right? That's the one that he made look like a microphone. You've seen that rocket. How did he get by with that? Nobody. Not one person said, "Hey, man." I wouldn't do that. Pulled off the best penis joke there ever was in the history of penis jokes on TV. Nobody said nothing. Every radio, every news station, every TV station, CNN, Fox News, all of them broadcasting a tight shot of that rocket. Right behind Anderson Cooper's head. Nobody said nothing. Tell me we're the only one to notice that. Anyway, this craft lit at the bottom of Sugarloaf Mountain. I thought, oh Lord, somebody's hurting that. And I run up there and I pop the top off of this craft and out step one of the most beautiful creatures I've ever seen to this day. First thing I noticed was her big green eye. I said, you want to go on a date? She said, I'd love to. Or, turned out we had a lot in common, you know? We went on a date. You know, I taught her how to play the auto harp. She taught me how to probe. End up getting married and having a little baby we named. They disappeared 2 years ago Thanksgiving, Area 51. So about a year ago, I got all these people on Facebook gathered up to storm the gates of Area 51. Y'all remember that? That was me. I wasn't going in there with them. I always found it a bad idea to storm a military base. So I encouraged them, though. I'm like, hey, if you see, tell her daddy loves her. As a tribute, we put this song on the record, and it became the title track, a little song called Blue. One, two, three. Here's a story about a little guy that lives in a blue world. And all day and all night, everything he plays is just blue light. Inside and outside, blue his outfit, the blue little weapons and the blue Corvette. And everything is blue for him and himself and everybody around. But you can't get nobody to listen. I'm blue, I'm
inside me. and himself and everybody around, cause he ain't got nobody to listen.
This one to anybody out there that might be celebrating a broken heart this evening. Please, somebody with a broken heart, please come down and let us talk about your farming. I knew I could do that here because there's some places I can't do that because folks will get up. Tell me about their broken heart. Sometimes it's uncomfortable. We just say it to be funny. But if there's nobody with a broken heart, it is our prayer that maybe by the end of this evening, somebody here will have a broken heart. And that way this song can be there to comfort you in your time of need. This little song called Owner of a Lonely Heart. Shake.